With the launch of the Xbox Series X and PS5 right around the corner, I figured now would be a good time to discuss the obvious issues that we're going to be having during the launch cycle of this next generation of consoles. Now, there will probably be issues during the life cycle of this next generation, but today we're basically going to be talking about the launch, the issues that are going to be really rampant during the first couple months of these consoles being out. First of all, we know the price point of both of these consoles already. The higher end ones costing basically $500 and the lower end ones costing about $300. Price point isn't a huge issue here. I mean, we saw it last generation with the Xbox One and the PS4, Xbox One being $500 at launch. Now, both companies have taken different marketing approaches to trying to get people to want to go to these consoles. Microsoft being super consumer friendly, being like, hey, whatever you play on, you're good, we're all friends here. And PlayStation being like, we got a ton of exclusives, a ton of really good first party games, this is why you want to come to PS5. Spec-wise, I believe the Xbox Series X is slightly better than the PS5, but in the end game of it all, specs only matter so much. It's really going to come down to who plays what in your friends group and what games you want to play. I myself really enjoy Xbox games, so I plan on getting the Series X. But there's going to be a major issue with obtaining a console at launch. Number one, there is a very limited supply. When the PS5 and the Xbox Series X first went on pre-order, they pretty much sold out almost immediately. People were camping outside of GameStops to try to get their hands on a pre-order of the console. People were constantly refreshing the websites on different retailers in order to attempt to get the pre-order off on these consoles. And when I was browsing the Xbox subreddit when the pre-orders were going live for the Series X, the GameStops that people were posting, they were like, they had like two Series X's and two Series S's. Some of them had more, some of them had less. And I think that really speaks volumes as to how difficult it will probably be right at launch to get your hands on a new console. Now, maybe production has been ramped up, but obviously there is a pandemic going on. A lot of things shut down earlier in this year. While things are coming back now, the fact that manufacturing was probably stopped for a good amount of time is probably a good indicator that there's not going to be as many consoles available at launch, especially seeing that GameStop only had five consoles that you could pre-order in their physical retailer. And if you go on Xbox's website, literally every single retailer that they associate with that you can get the new generation of Xbox from is sold out. You can't get it. There's obviously going to be scalpers, people who are going to try to overcharge you. You need to hold off on that. That's how they make their money. They're going to buy it for full price and try to charge you maybe double. Hopefully these scalpers get a taste of their own medicine and they're not able to sell their product because, well, people should be pretty privy to the fact that scalpers are out there. Don't fall into it. I know you want a console at launch. I do too. Don't give any more money than you would have to give a retailer. So the very limited number of consoles is going to be a huge pitfall. I don't know exactly, I haven't heard the announcement from whether Sony or Microsoft about their production cycle now, whether there's going to be a ton more at launch or what the deal is, but as it stands right now, pre-orders, it was pretty barren. You had to get the luck of the draw. Out of my friend group of maybe, let's say, 10 people that I play Xbox with constantly, I think like two or three of them were able to get a pre-order off, me not being one of them. So the odds of me being able to go to a retailer on the day of launch and get an Xbox Series X, probably pretty slim, though the option is there. Then there's also the issue of price. If you looked at the storage for the Xbox Series X, it comes with an internal 1TB SSD. And even with the current generation of consoles, storage is pretty limited. I have an Xbox One S right now with a 2TB external. That is pretty much filled for me right now. While, yes, I could uninstall a bunch of games, I have 67 games installed, I play like 5 of them. I like having the option of all those games there. So obviously with the next generation of consoles being, you know, really heavily SSD focused for those faster loading times, and obviously better hardware will come, better graphics, better performance. Games are going to take up a lot of space. I mean, Modern Warfare, like with Warzone, already takes up like 100 to 200 gigs, so expect your hard drives to fill up pretty quickly. And you can purchase the 1 terabyte expansion for the Xbox Series X. It's a 1 terabyte SSD. You can still use your regular hard disks, those externals. You just won't get the benefits of an SSD. And those things are like $220. It's a proprietary thing. So like Microsoft partnered with, I think it was Seagate. They partner with somebody to make these 1 terabyte expansions, and you are paying essentially half of the price of the console for this SSD. It's expensive. This console generation is going to be expensive. Not to mention controllers and whatnot, those basically costing the amount of a full-priced game for every single console, whether you're playing on Switch, Xbox, or PlayStation. Controllers are a whole other thing. At least the really good thing about this generation of consoles is that all of your previous hardware will move up to the next generation of consoles. So if I do get an Xbox Series X, but I want to use my custom controller that I have for the Xbox One, I can use that. I can use the same headset. No need to buy a ton of new equipment. That's a big plus. I just think the main issue you're going to be seeing with the launch of these consoles is people not being able to get their hands on it in an appropriate manner. I hope I'm wrong. I hope this video ages very poorly and that people are able to get their hands on these things really quickly. Hopefully there's no major hardware issues. I feel like there shouldn't be, but you never know. Xbox has hopefully learned from the 360 era. They took a massive hit with that Red Ring of Death. So hopefully they've done major testing on all ends of consoles. What do you guys think about this new generation of consoles? Are you excited? Did you actually even get a pre-order off? Hopefully this console launch will go a little bit smooth, but with the, you know, COVID-19 thing going on, everyone needs to stay safe in some way. So if they offer contactless delivery, make sure you take advantage of that. Wear your mask when you're out in public, especially if you're going to these console launches, and just remember to be safe, everybody. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Cheerio, mates!